Hi, and welcome to Rapid Respiratory Review, and today we're going to be talking about inhaled nitric oxide. It's used as home therapy in order to improve oxygenation and decrease the need for ECMO by acting as a potent pulmonary vasodilator. So what are the benefits? It's been used to reduce incidence of chronic lung disease, and so it decreases BPD because you have less days on the ventilator, and it's used to decrease incidence of pulmonary hypertension and right-to-left shunting. So it does this by dilating the pulmonary circuit and decreasing the preload on it. It's shown to improve neurodevelopment, so you're able to develop further once you're at the age of 2. It's shown to increase cognition at that point. Indications. It's only used in neonates greater than 34 weeks, babies with hypoxic respiratory failure, a gradient post and preductal saturation indicating right to left shunting, electrocardiographic evidence, and an oxygen index of greater than 25, in which your oxygen index is equal to your mean P airway times your FiO2 over your PaO2. So how is it used? The initial dose is typically 20 parts per million, but it can go as high as 80, but there's a higher chances of side effects. The optimal dose is given when the lung is maximally inflated, just like if you're giving puffers. Once established, iNO is typically reduced by 50%. So if you gave the initial dose of 20, you would go down to 10 and further, but you would base that off your oxygen index. So when you're titrating it, your oxygen index has to be less than 10 and your FiO2 is lower, so 60-80%. Until you get down to 1 part per million, in which inhaled nitric oxide can be discontinued. During the decrease of your inhaled nitric oxide, you also want to increase your FiO2 to prevent recurrent pulmonary hypertension. This is due to the inhaled nitric oxide having a short half-life, and so it'll dilate your pulmonary vessels quick, but it's not going to last for a long time. So oxygen also is a potent pulmonary vasodilator, so you need that oxygen to maintain them open. Side effects of inhaled nitric oxide is it can combine with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide, and if not properly monitored, it can lead to methemoglobinemia. So if it's leading to methemoglobinemia, that's a dyshemoglobin, and you're not going to have the saturation. So despite you having high oxygen concentration around, you're not going to be able to properly deliver the oxygen to the tissue. I did read that there was some speculation that you could use inhaled nitric oxide for ARDS, but it's not thoroughly studied. That's all for today. Have a great day.